August of 1990, Kurt Cobain was dating Toby Vail. She was a drummer for a band called Bikini Kill. One night, Kurt went out drinking with Bikini Kill's lead singer, Kathleen Hanna, in Olympia, Washington. At the end of the night, both completely wrecked, Kurt and Kathleen returned to their hotel. Now, Kathleen at the time was in a feud with Toby Vail, Kurt's girlfriend and the drummer in her band, and thought that Toby was a toxic influence on him. Now, bear with me. Teen Spirit was a trendy brand of girls' deodorant at the time, and one that Kathleen knew that Toby used. So as Kurt slept, Kathleen snuck into his room with a can of spray paint and tagged, "Kurt smells like Teen Spirit," on the bedroom wall, implying that Kurt had been marked with Toby's scent, literally and metaphorically. Now, when Kurt woke up and saw the literal writing on the wall, he had no idea what it meant. He didn't know what Teen Spirit deodorant was, and he assumed that the slogan was just an ode to his rebelliousness and independence. It was a compliment. More importantly, he thought it would be a really great title for a song. Now, the last piece. Kurt came into rehearsal the next week with the riff that would become Smells Like Teen Spirit, and the band hated it. They thought it was way too mainstream for these self-proclaimed anti-establishment, anti-media grungers. And the song stood out from other Nirvana songs because it was different. Kurt would later admit that he'd written it after he'd heard a Pixies song called Tame with its heavy chorus and lighter verse. Kurt would actually tell Rolling Stone that, quote, "I was trying to rip off the Pixies." Regardless, the band hated the riff, and as retribution, Kurt made the band play it for an hour and a half straight in some kind of Stockholm Syndrome attempt. Eventually, Dave Grohl, the band's drummer, convinced Kurt to slow the tempo a bit and added the song's iconic beat. And the rest, my friends, is rock and roll history, which is something that I have always wanted to say.